Hello everyone. Today we will discuss again the topic from mechatronics, which is A2D converters. So basically objective of this video is to study analog to digital converters, that is ADC, and outcome will be the student will be able to explain analog to digital converters. Basically we are moving through the types of A2D converters. We have already seen what are the flash AD converters and successive approximation A2D converters. So in this video, particularly, we will be dealing with dual slope A2D converters. One thing I want to mention here about these types, that flash ADC and successive approximation ADC are direct type ADCs, while the dual slope type ADC is indirect type ADC. So what is the difference? So in flash and successive approximation, we directly converted the input analog voltage into a digital form or digital number. And in dual slope, what is the difference is, or why we call it as indirect, is dual slope ADC will convert the input analog voltage in terms of time, and that time will be converted in form of a digital number. That's why it is called as a indirect type ADC, or rather we are going to measure time for the conversion rate, and that time will be mentioned as a number or rather digital form. So it is called as a indirect type ADC. So that was the basic difference between these two types, that is direct type ADC and indirect type ADC. So flash and successive approximations are the types of direct type, while the dual slope is the indirect type ADC. Okay, so now elements of dual slope ADC. Main elements are, we need an integrator here. So integrating operational amplifier is included in the circuit. Then a comparator. Obviously, we know what is the use of comparator here. Again, we are going to compare two voltages, and accordingly the comparator will give output. Logic gate for again starting and stopping a counter, and a binary counter which will count the time pulses or clock pulses, and accordingly there will be conversion of a signal, input signal, into an output digital form. Okay, so these are different components or elements of a dual slope ADC. Now let's go for the circuit diagram. Here, see, we are having an integrator here. So operational amplifier as an integrating circuit is given here, which is having a resistor R and a capacitor C is in feedback loop. We know how an integrating op amp works. Okay, so here we know the output of this op amp will be equal to minus 1 upon RC into integration of V input in DT. So that will be the output of this op amp. Then again we are having a comparator here, used for comparing two voltages. The output coming from the integrating op amp is connected to non-inverting end. And inverting end of the comparator is grounded. So we know that at negative terminal of comparator we are having the value 0 volts. Okay, then the output will be fed to a control gate, which is AND gate, and we are going to provide a clock pulse to an AND gate. So this AND gate will give an output. We know the properties of AND gate also. When both the inputs are high, AND gate will give high output, otherwise the output will be low, which is again provided to a binary counter. Then the binary counter will start and the conversion will start. How the conversion takes place, we'll going through before that. Again, this binary counter is connected with some switch here. So basically for the conversion of an analog input voltage, we need here two inputs. So the one is the VA, which is the analog voltage which we need to convert, which is an unknown voltage, and we are going to supply some constant reference voltage also. So there is a switch which will be switching in between VA and VREF, particularly while running the cycle of the conversion. So again, one thing to mention here is the VA and VREF must be of opposite polarities. Means if the VA signal is a positive voltage, then the VREF must be a negative voltage, and if VA is negative voltage, the VREF provided must be a positive voltage. So switch will obviously switch between the VA and VREF during the cycle. So let's go through the working now. Suppose we are going to connect here some negative analog input voltage VA to this integrating op amp. The input will be given, okay, and then as it is a negative voltage, we know the output of an operational amplifier will be minus 1 upon RC into VA dt. So this will give negative into negative, some positive value will be provided here. So some VO, suppose some VO positive voltage will be provided at the non-inverting terminal of or positive terminal of a comparator. So here we are having some positive VO value, and here we are having zero. So we know the comparator will compare between these two. So negative is less than positive, so obviously the output of this comparator will be high, that is one. And when we are going to giving the clock pulse here, so both the values will be high at that time. This AND gate will give high, that will start this binary counter. Okay, here we have shown a 4-bit binary counter. So what's going to happen here, as the counter is going to start counting, at the same time this capacitor is going to start charging because of this negative voltage VA, and continuously this time will be this counted here. And at particular time, as it is a 4-bit counter here, after 16 cycles it's going to overflow. Okay, so when the counter gets overflow, that is counting is done, it will again reset to zero. At that time what's going to happen, this signal is given to the switch, and switch is going to now change the input from this VA to this VREF. Okay, so what's going to happen here now, as this signal has changed from VA to V reference, but counter is still integrator is still integrating, so we cannot directly erase whatever is present there. So what is going to happen now, as V rep is positive, again this will be generating some negative voltage, so this capacitor is going to start discharging first. Okay, so as it's going to integrate the input voltage, the capacitor is going to continuously discharge. Okay, and at this time also this counter is counting continuously, and as this capacitor is going to discharge completely, it will reach to zero value, and then once it reaches zero, it will start to go in negative side, because it is continuously integrating, and we are providing V reference continuously here. So in first cycle it will integrate the VA continuously, so there will be some charging of this capacitor, and after switching again VREF, because of opposite polarity, it will start discharging and it will go to zero. After beyond zero, what's going to happen, this value at this terminal will be zero, and as it is going to negative side, so this will become less, and the comparator will give a low, because of which this AND gate gives a low, and because of this, this binary counter is going to stop. And as the binary counter is going to stop, whatever the time pulses measured will be given to this output latch, and a digital output related to this, that time measured, will be given as an output of this A to D converter. Okay, so I think picture is now got clear. Okay, So basically what's going to happen, this integrator will continuously integrate whatever the signal is given to it. And firstly, we are going to supply some negative voltage, which will be giving some positive output from the integrator, which is connected to positive terminal of a comparator. So comparator will give high, because of that again AND gate is going to again give high. And the time period will be again based on the clock pulses provided. Okay, so in next slide we will be going through the graph why this ADC is called as a dual slope, that will be studied. Okay, so here you can see here, so as I mentioned you, when we are going to supply firstly the input voltage VA, which is a negative voltage, it's going to give me a positive output voltage. So particular time period is shown up to the counter will get overflow. Up to that time the capacitor will get charged continuously, and as we are going to supply negative input voltage, whatever the output voltage we are going to get will be a positive voltage. That's why this is a positive slope here, and the time period will be fixed. So first half of the time will be fixed. So according to the value of input voltage, we can get different sloped lines here at the input side. Okay, it is called as a ramp up. So ramp up voltage when the capacitor is charging. So this time period is again based on the clock cycle. Okay, then once the clock counter gets overflown, it will reset and it will switch over from V into VREP. Now VREP is a positive value, so that's why the output got from the integrator will be a negative value. So because of that negative value, capacitor is discharging continuously, and once it gets zero, beyond that value it try to go, then the counter will stop counting, and that time will be counted, which is again proportional to the value of V in, as whatever the V in supplied. See here, you can see for this first half, the time period required for charging is same, whatever may be the input voltage. So we are having different slope line here, the red lines which you are seeing on the screen, different slope red lines. Okay, slopes are varying, and at the second part, these blue lines you can see are having same slope but the different time period. So this time period for going from this some particular value to zero required for each input will be different according to the as the input voltage is going to be very high, the charging of a capacitor will be at higher value, and from that value it needs to go to zero, it will require more amount of time. So this time required will be again more in case of higher input voltage. Okay, so this time is now measured, which is proportional with the input voltage, and at particular value when counter stops, whatever the binary value of this pulses measured will be given at an output. So this is the output digital value for an input voltage. Now we'll go through few mathematical formulations here. We know V out of an integrator is equal to 1 by R minus 1 by RC into integration of V in dt, let's say for time period 0 to t. So this is total, that means from this point, for this value of V in 1, from this point to this point, whatever the time required is t, let's say V in dt, which is equal to, say here there are two parts. Firstly, it will be integrating the voltage VA, which is our supplied analog voltage, which is unknown voltage. So and then after a particular time, when the clock the up counter overflows and resets, it will change to VREP. So again this will integrate this VREP also. So integrator will integrate VA as well as VREP. So minus 1 upon rc we have taken common, 0 to some for particular, see this initial time t, so let's say t1, so 0 to t1 v dt plus t1 to t v rep dt. So what we can say here, v0 is equal to minus 1 upon rc va into t1 plus v rep into t minus t1, so t minus t1. But we know that at this point voltage has become 0. As capacitor is discharging, so we can take V out 0 for a particular period. So from this we can say that T minus T1 is equal to mod of VA upon VRF into T1. As we are having this value, we know VA is negative, we have taken VA negative and VRF positive, so this will become positive, okay, right? So to avoid confusion, let's say mod of VA by VREP. So T will be 1 plus VA by VREP into T1. Here see the time T1, which is equal to 2 power n into T clock. What is 2 power n into T clock? So this is the time required to for an up counter to get overflow, right? 2 power n. So we have already discussed it, as we have mentioned 4 bit up counter in the diagram, so it is 2 power 4 will 16, so it will count up to 16, so that is from 0 1 2 to 15 it will count, and after 15 it will again reset to 0. As we know, a 4 bit counter can measure from, see, 4 bits means 0 0 0 0 to 1 1 1 1, and we know binary 1 1 1 1 is equal to decimal 15. So from 0 to 15 it will count and it will get reset to again 0. So it is 2 power n t clock. Okay, so the time required, so 2 power n, because again it will measure 0 and then it will reset as it has overflown. So 2 power n t clock. So that is the value of t1 here actually. So this value, okay. So again it is dependent on the number of bits which we have mentioned here, 4 bit. So likewise n bit cycle, if you are going to use n bit counter, up counter, so that will be t1 is equal to 2 power n into t clock. T clock is the pulse provided, okay. So from this we can calculate t max and t min. So maximum time required is 2 power n plus 1 into t clock, and minimum time is 2 power n t clock, okay. By taking value of va is equal to v rep for t max and taking v is equal to 0 for t min, okay. Again you can see here time of conversion t is independent of the components like r and c. Here only v and v, va and v rep, which we are going to provide, will be responsible for time of conversion here, okay. So total time of conversion t required here will be 1 plus mod of va by v rep whole into t. T1. So, and T1 is again known to us, which is 2 power n T clock, okay. So, as we can say here, it is independent of the components like R and C. That's why we can say this is very highly accurate A to D converter. I hope you have understood all the things here. Again, to mention the slope here, I have again shown the same diagram with simple one input and output. So here we are having this line, which is integration of this part, and here minus 1 upon RC into VA will be our slope of the line. But as VA is negative, taken VA is taken as negative, the whole value become positive, that's why it is having a positive slope. And then from this point the slope is negative because V rep taken is positive. So here minus 1 upon RC into V rep will be the slope. So as VA is positive, this will be a negative value slope, it is negative slope, okay. So this was regarding the dual slope ADC. Let's go towards the next slide, which is again pros and cons of a dual slope A to D converter. Pros, obviously we have gone through the advantages, that is it is a highly accurate A to D converter because it avoids the components like our resistor and capacitor in the circuit. It will be only dependent on the input voltages supplied, that is input voltage, unknown time input voltage, as well as the reference voltage which we are going to supply. Then fewer adverse effects from the noise, because R and C are totally avoided. So because of the heating of those element, it will not be any affected. Okay, so this was about advantages. Again, disadvantages, it is very slow. This is the main disadvantage of this dual slope A2D converter. This is the slowest converter among all A2D converters, because it will take 2 power n plus 1 T clock cycles for conversion of the value, which is the high amount of time. So this is slowest, but it is highest accurate. And again, accuracy is dependent on the use of precision external components. So, like accuracy will be dependent on the other components like comparator, up counter, etc., etc., switch. So that will be one of the cons. So basically, main advantage is highly accurate, and main disadvantage is slowest. So where accuracy matters, we can go for this dual slope of ADC, and where we need a quick conversion rate, there we can go for flash ADC. So it will directly convert value in one cycle only, one clock cycle. Okay, so this was regarding dual slope A2D converter. Thank you.